Welcome to this new episode of The Trend Talk. Belle, I'm literally still on a high from preparing this episode because we have some amazing guests.
Okay, now that word high is really popular nowadays because, you know, they just legalized recreational marijuana in California. That makes 8 states that have legalized it, but you're not talking about that high.
I'm not talking about that high. I'm high on life. I love life. But you know what? How do you feel about the legalization of recreational marijuana? Because medicinal marijuana has been legal for quite some time.
Recreational marijuana, I think it puts marijuana on the same level as alcohol. You know, alcohol is legal, yet it impairs your driving abilities. It makes you rowdy, or, you know, it does things to your body.
It alters you in some way, shape, or form.
So in that sense, it's put it, you know, you still have to be 21 to smoke the marijuana, so you can't just do it if you're underage. But you know what happens is a lot of kids who are underage, we're going to try it.
That's
right. So it's right there like alcohol. You know, we're going to have the same problems.
But I think also some solutions come from it, because a lot of states have been getting fiscal, hookups because of this, for lack of a better term, for example.
Well, because there's taxes that are not going to be given to the government, because people are going to pay taxes on their weed.
Right, exactly. So, for example, in Colorado, and let me quote this, according to an analysis from the Marijuana Policy Group, in Colorado, legal weed has created more than 18,000 full-time jobs and added about $2.4 billion to the state's economy last year. That's amazing. I mean, and
that's the upside of weed.
That's the upside. And I looked into some of the different things that have happened in Colorado, and a lot of the money goes to education. So it's like, to me, hey, if you're going to smoke, you might as well make the society and community better by giving giving a cut.
Let's hope that money
education.
Really goes to education, because, you know,
bureaucracy,
exactly.
Blah, blah, blah.
But if that's the case and it really goes, you know, I'm glad. That's a good thing. And that businesses are thriving, and that there's jobs being created. That's all great.
Right. A lot of entrepreneurs are taking advantage of this new economic boom of weed and getting rich.
Right. But, you know, there is the medicinal purposes, because marijuana has been used for medicinal purposes for centuries, for centuries. And some say that, you know, they squashed the marijuana use so that the medical industry can, you know, control what is given and make money off of it.
Right.
But, you know, there's some good things that supposedly marijuana does. It helps with epilepsy, with cancer, with ADD.
With stress.
With stress. Right? Oh, yeah. You know, a little joint and problems are over. Well, I don't know, but they say.
They say Crohn's disease. Remember that movie with Cheech and Chong? What would they?
Up in smoke?
Up in smoke. That kind of, that's my image of marijuana use. That's what I, because I didn't.
Stoners.
Stoners, right.
Because I do know people who've been smoking marijuana since they were in high school, and they're a little slow.
But you're not supposed to smoke it that young. I mean, I've read some articles that say that when you start using.
When you start real young, like at 14.
Right, because your brain is still developing. It does change some kind of things in your brain, so I don't think it's a good idea. Just because they legalize it or it's recreational, that doesn't mean kids should start smoking left and right, because I think that's the downside.
Though. That's the thing, is that they will.
But
do
they will
I mean?
Regardless if it's
yes,
legal or not. And there's other downsides, right?
Yeah, okay, so one of the downsides, it's still, if you get cancer from smoking, you're still going to get cancer by smoking weed, but of course there's edibles and you don't have to smoke it, but a lot of people like to smoke it, and that still messes up your lungs and all
that. Right, the smoke.
Yeah, and then?
It's a gateway to heavy drugs, according to some people, I mean, how can you prove that it's a gateway to drugs, right?
I think the gateway to drugs are the doctors who are prescribing all of these opiates.
Right.
Because that's an epidemic. But, you know, like you said, it does affect kids. If you start smoking it really early, it impairs your
cognitive thinking.
Yes. Yes, because you're, like you said, your brain's not that. But also,
are you sure we didn't smoke some? Because I think we're a little slow right now.
And also, one of the interesting things that I want to know about is that it's going to put the drug dealers out of the marijuana business.
But that's good, because the drug dealers, I mean, that's an underground business where a lot of shady things can happen.
But what if they start pushing the heavier stuff? The coke and the heroin and all
that.
Yeah,
but we're that's another discussion. This is specifically
weed. No, but I'm saying
weed.
That, you know,
you mean the
they're
going to
lose out on that, but they're going to make more money on the other drugs.
Well, we can continue discussing this until forever and ever, but we got to go because right in our studio is Katie Waters. We're going to interview her. She's a up-and-coming singer. She's amazing. She's a Latina, and she's making things happen, right?
Right.
That and more on the Trend Talk after the break.